Hi, everybody. It is December 11th, Sunday. We had a great time last night. The immediate family got to play our last gig of the year at the Mint in Los Angeles. And the place was packed and just really a great audience. It was a fun evening because there were two other bands on the bill with us. And so it was a real nice evening. I'm just sitting and listening to other people play, which I always enjoy. I always take advantage of when we do gigs and there's other acts on the bill of being supportive and hanging out and checking them out. And there's been times where they've completely blown me away and I just start contacting people and go, check these people out. They're really good. And so we had a great time and we're pretty much done on this coming Tuesday, day after tomorrow. We have a photo shoot that we're doing for a bunch of promo stuff. And then that's it until January when we head back east to do some gigs back in the New York area. I think we're in Connecticut, New Jersey, and New York. It's a brief run back there, but I look forward to that. That'll be fun. And then I'll be just working on songs for Lyle Lovett, and I'll be heading out with Lyle. I think our tour starts on January 30th, I think is the first gig, and we'll be out for about 5 weeks in the South this time. I think they just didn't want to head north during those months, during the winter months. So we got this run down there, and it's just going to, as of right now, I think it's just four of us. I think it's just Lyle and Jeff White and Luke Bulla and myself. There may be a possible addition beyond that that I'm not aware of right now, but it's going to be a pretty much an acoustic run, which will be a fun thing to do after having spent the summer doing the large band and being out there with 16 other players. So we have adventures await, and then we have stuff coming on. We got the new album coming out with the band, and then the documentary is going to a whole bunch more film festivals. So lots of good things going on here. But I wanted to get in a little bit of music, and then I got a bunch of stuff to take care of around the house. I'm so grateful. I looked at when I got this morning, last night it was raining really hard, and then I got this morning and it was still raining really hard. Right now I'm looking out the window and I see all these gray clouds, but I'm seeing a band coming up over the hill of blue skies. So I'm not sure if it's going to be behind us now or if there's more to come. I really don't know. But I'm just grateful for every drop we get here in the West, because we are definitely hurting for water. So that's that. So, but today I thought I'd go back, because it was interesting when I was at the, when we played the Coach House the other night. I was surprised a whole bunch of people that had nothing to do with each other and at different times came up and they said, God, one of our favorite things was when you played with Cecilio and Kapono. Now, I did one of my videos quite some time back talking about Cecilio and Kapono, and so I thought I'd go back and revisit a couple more songs from that and a little more stuff, but there's a bunch of information on the previous video. But I pulled up a little thing here on Wikipedia, and so for anybody that maybe isn't going to go back and check it out, it says Cecilio and Kapono were a Hawaiian pop music duo formed in 1973 by Henry Kapono, known professionally as Henry Kapono. I can't even pronounce Kai Ahue. That has his name, but he was born in 48, and he and Cecilio David Rodriguez, who was born in 1945. The duo released three albums on Columbia Records, the self-titled Cecilio and Kapono, Elua, E-L-U-A, and Night Music. To date, the duo has released more than a dozen full-length albums, which have incorporated various genres, including top 40 pop, modern soul, funk, disco, rock, and traditional Hawaiian. Individually, the two artists have also released numerous solo recordings. Cecilio and Kapono received the Hawaiian Academy of Recording Arts Lifetime Achievement Award for their work as a duo in 2009. So I'm going to go back and dig into what we have here. The musicians on this album, this is the first one from 1974, their self-titled album, Cecilio and Kapono. And It was myself on bass. There's a couple of other tracks that the great Wilton Felder played bass on, who was also a great sax player. Russ Kunkel on drums, David Page and Craig Durge on keyboards, Cecilio on guitar, Henry on acoustic guitar, and Cecilio also played acoustic guitar and also played sitar, J.D. Manis on steel, Larry McNeely on banjo, Jim Horn on flute, sax, Gary Coleman on marimba, and Bobby Hall on percussion. And the vocals are Henry and Cecilio. So and it was produced by Mike Stewart, arranged by the strings that were arranged by Jimmy Haskell, and the concertmaster was the great Sid Sharp. And it was mastered at Artisan Sound Recorders, and we recorded it at Devonshire Studios. So I'm going to go ahead and jump off of this page, see what else I had right here. I think that pretty much covered that, so I'm just going to play some music. So here's a song called Sunflower. And this is Cecilio Kapono's self-titled album from 1974.
If this were a flower garden, and your smiling face a flower therein, sunflower with a golden hair, I would know you anywhere. I could visit no difference in the darkness, you shine bright. Sunflower with the eyes of blue, I'd do everything just for you. La 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 la. Take you in my arms and then sunflower, I will take you there. It'd be our garden, be our garden everywhere. Thank you.
the smiling face a flower there is.
Sunflower with the eyes of blue, I do everything just for you.
I always loved duos like that. I mean, when I got to work, you know, with Hall and Oates and all these, and you think, you know, there's so much of that period of like Seals and Croft and stuff when these guys would find each other and they just had this really cool thing that would happen when they came together. Here's a song called Sunshine Love. Here we go. The album cover on this was great. It's a Hawaiian shirt on the album cover with their pictures on it. So Cecilio Kapono, and it's got an old airplane flying and palm trees and stuff. It's really a beautiful cover.
Sun.
pretty great. I mean, it goes like from Seals and Croft into a like a Stephen Stills moment, and then you throw in a little Jimmy Buffett in there, and it's great. Here's one called, this is the last one I'll do right now. It's called Song for Someone. Here we go. Get to that downbeat.
Trying to concentrate on something that's fresh in my mind. The dogs are barking, the traffic's passing, and my tongue is tied. But I can't hear a single word I'm singing. I can't hear a single note I'm playing. And I guess it's the wrong time, the wrong time, the wrong time of day.
Why it does that?
I guess it's the wrong time, the wrong time, the wrong time of day. To write a song. Trying to write a song for someone that I love so dear. And if it takes me all night long, I'd sing it when I'm through. But I can't hear a single word I'm singing. I can't hear a single note I'm playing. And I guess it's the wrong time, the wrong time, the wrong time of day. I guess it's the wrong time, the wrong time, the wrong time of day. Write a song.
Good stuff. Yeah, it was such a fertile period back in that kind of 70 to, well, through the whole 70s, but especially the early 70s, yeah, kind of 70 to 75. There were so many fine singer-songwriters that were emerging after the advent of James Taylor's hitting the scene. And all of a sudden, it took a viability, and all the labels started searching out all kinds of singer-songwriters. So, it was really great. Oh, this is fine. I just noticed there's somebody You gave me this at the gig last night here. I always get stuff from people, oh man, you did more lockup than anybody we've ever seen on Facebook. Yeah, I'm sure there's more to come on there. It's always a double-edged sword dealing with Facebook. There's parts of it I just completely loathe, but there's other parts that happen that I just go, man, you know, the hookups and people that I've rekindled relationships with that I would never have found had it not been for that format. So you have to just kind of temper each post and things like that. So, okay, I'm going to get going. I got lots to do today. And yesterday was my wife's birthday, and she had to spend it at the Mint last night. So we're going out with some friends tonight and actually celebrate with a nice dinner and everything. So looking forward to that. So I will see you all tomorrow. I'm hoping for a little more rain. It's hard to tell now. Blue sky's getting a little more intense, but maybe some more will come in. So till next time, take good care. Bye-bye.